Do you want hair like this and boing boings like these? I'll teach you how after the short intro. You probably learned in your physics class that a vector has its x and y components. Well, when you're making your model in live 2D, you gotta think about the movement in terms of its components. You can apply this general principle not just in hair and boobs, but also for accessories and clothes. For physics, we have to make and rig the parameters first before playing around in the physics window. Okay, now for hair, the biggest components of movement are swaying and bouncing. Let's talk about swaying first. If you really want to save on the number of deformers you'll use, you can just use one deformer and assign two parameters to it. Here's what the movement looks like. Don't forget to synthesize corners after. You can also use multiple nested deformers with an assigned parameter each for more flowy movement. Each deformer bends at certain points, and once you get closer to the end of the hair, the points get closer and closer to each other. This is kind of like how skinning in live 2D works. I just don't use skinning a lot for the swaying component since I don't have a lot of influence to the movement after. And it's kind of hard for me to rig the bouncing component when I use skinning. But if you want me to show you how I rigged Emika's model using skinning, let me know in the comments. For the bouncing component, I like to use one or two deformers depending on how long the hair is. And if you want to use more deformers for longer hair, you can just add a little child deformer there. I use two parameters per deformer in the bouncing component. One parameter is for the up and down movement, and the other one is for the fanning out and, I don't know, squeezing in of the hair? Alright, so I hope you're still here, because my god, the retention rate on my
previous
tutorial is pretty bad. It's a tutorial, man, you gotta watch it. And now, it's time for rigging while we're holding down. Gonna rig breasts. It doesn't matter if the breasts look like egg yolks on a pan. It's anime. So for this tutorial video, I'll be giving myself some better breasts because, man, look at this. Look how stiff they are. Look. Barely any movement. Come on. I'm not true big booby anime girl if my breasts don't bounce. There are two components for the breast. The first component is the X component, and the second one is the Y component. I use one deformer for each. The X component has a parameter for left and right movement, and there's another parameter for left and right movement too. And then the Y component has a parameter for up and down movement, and another one for when the breasts come together and separate. Alright, so there's a little change in scenery. I'm not in a circle anymore. So to go to the physics stuff, click modeling right here, and then open physics slash scene blending settings. We are going to create one group per component, so for the breasts, there's an X and Y component, so we're gonna create two groups. To create a group, click add, and then name it. I'm gonna name this breast X. And if you want to choose your presets here for the input and the pendulums, you can. But I personally don't use presets, so I'm gonna leave this blank for now. And over here, I'm just gonna click add here to get my input parameters. So these are the parameters that will cause the movement. So I'm gonna choose body X and body Z. And when you add these, make sure that they are not zero or else nothing's gonna happen. Like your love life. The same input type parameters, either position X or angle, should sum up to 100. Well, they can sum up to less if you'd like, I don't know, if you like the movement to be more subtle. And then we go over to the output settings right here. And if you don't have pendulums yet, add those in, baby! And then I'm going to start adding my output parameters by clicking add right here and searching for the parameters in this long ass list. Here. So you should assign a different pendulum number to each output parameter, or else they're just gonna have the same magnitude of movement. You can definitely add more
pendulum
and then put 2 here and then 4 here. Yeah, and you can just, you know, experiment what looks best. And you know what's left for you to do? Go out and play the blues and birds! And also play around with the scale and output magnitude. If you want to know what these mean, these durations, shaking, reaction, overall, blah 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 blah, I'm gonna put a link in the description so you can read the reference. I'm just going to continue working on the physics for the breast for that good ass booba, and I'll show you the results later. So for the breast Y stuff, here are my output parameter settings and pendulum settings, and here are my input settings, just body Y here, and then this is what it looks like. So I want to just say sorry for the head angles. I haven't updated my model in such a long time. Also, the hair movement is a little bit different because I was experimenting with, you know, nested deformers and just using a single deformer for the movement. Yeah, so this is what it looks like. There we go. Alright, and we're done. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked it, drop a like. And if you didn't like it, I don't know. Do whatever. And if you like my content, consider subscribing if you want more live 2D content. And if you want other kind of content, let me know in the comments if you're, like, you know, getting tired of live 2D. Alright, I'll see you in the next video. See ya. Kira.